Two things. First one, Judge Englemayer might be the most boss judge ever. And two, Tekashi might be on his way home.
Me and the Notification Gang would like to invite everybody to come join us Monday through Thursday, 9:20 to 10 o'clock for Morning Coffee, where we discuss the events of the prior day and also just talk mess about stuff. See you then.
Oh, Black Dynamite, I wish it was that simple, but this is much bigger than you and me.
Hey, little mama. It may be bigger than you, and it may be bigger than me, but it ain't bigger than you and me. Can you dig it?
BBN Jack Frost. What's up, party people? Alright, so... yeah. So, apparently, Judge Englemayer wants to release Tekashi 6ix9ine. Okay, so real quick, just so I can give you a real quick breakdown. Judge Englemayer had wanted to give Tekashi 6ix9ine, I believe it was bail before or a bond before, and he was not able to, or it was parole or probation. I forget which one, but it was one of the four, and he was not able to. And one of the reasons why he wasn't able to do this, because, you know, what he was trying to give him isn't the important part of the conversation. The important part is the why. It's because Tekashi 6ix9ine is currently in a protective custody. For everybody that don't know, Tekashi 6ix9ine and his lawyers argued to the judge and to the government that his life is in danger. So therefore, since his life is in danger, he cannot be in a regular prison. So therefore, instead of going to a regular jail like MCC or the MDC, that's not regular jail, those are federal lockups. But instead of going to one of those places and staying there, he was sent somewhere where he could get some protection because he was going to be taking a stand on the 9 Trey Gangsta Bloods. So that is specifically why they removed him from regular population and put him into protective population. Now, this is the problem. The prison that Tekashi 6ix9ine was sent to, the jail, whatever the case is, that he was sent to operates outside of the DOC. At least this is the way that I was told it. It operates outside of the DOC. So when Judge Englemayer was trying to reach out and get these things going on that would allow for Tekashi 6ix9ine to be freed, Judge Englemayer obviously was reaching out because of Lance Lazaro. For everybody that don't know, Dawn Florio and Lance Lazaro are Tekashi 6ix9ine's lawyers. So when they, you know, did their due diligence and they was going to try to reach out and go through the paperwork and everything else, so Judge Englemayer could then stamp the thing, bang, go home, they weren't able to. And the reason being is that Tekashi 6ix9ine is not currently in the DOC. At least he wasn't. So therefore, the paperwork could never get to the desk where it could get stamped at. He would first need to be let out of the particular situation that he's in, the protective custody, which they can't let him out of because he obviously needs it. Okay, so this is where Judge Englemayer comes in. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to read you something that some paperwork that basically speaks on the Judge Englemayer situation and basically gives you a better understanding of what's been going on. Could I say shout out to Inner City Press? He tweeted this out. At Inner City Press, all lowercase. I don't know. Are you supposed to say all lowercase? I don't know. Anyway, he says on 6ix9ine, for those understandably asking if Inner City Press first report on SDNY live order signaling 6ix9ine release unless U.S. convinces him he can't is the April Fool's joke. His Judge Englemayer's order is dated April 1st, but I doubt he'd joke on Pacer. Okay, so when I first heard about this, just so we could be clear, I was like, man, that damn Inner City Press, he's trying to, this is a game. No, it's not a game. It's actually 100% true. Judge Englemayer actually signed some papers forcing the government's hand, and we'll find out by 5 o'clock today whether Tekashi 6ix9ine is going to be a free man. The letter says, Judge Englemayer writes a letter and he says, the court has received an application from counsel for Daniel Hernandez. Counsel obviously is Lance Lazaro and Dawn Florio. And it says, representing the Bureau of Prisons has now denied his request for compassionate relief and that the courts review his application to convert the balance of his term of imprisonment to a term of home confinement is now administratively proper. And the reason why I think they're saying administratively proper is because, like I was just explaining to you, they weren't in a position, I believe, to even get the paperwork to the desk that it needed to be stamped on. So that might be what they're alluding to. I'm not 100% sure. It goes on to say the court directs that the government respond by no later than 5 p.m. today. The parties are advised that, provided that the court has legal authority to grant the relief requested by defense counsel, the court intends to do so. So ordered. So basically, this is how I'm taking this, just so we could be clear. I'm taking it as Judge Englemayer saying, let the man go. If you don't let him go, I'm gonna go through the proper chain of the proper steps to free him myself. It's on you. That's literally how that sounds to me. I can be wrong, but that's how that sounds to me. It sounds to me like the judge is saying, look, it don't make sense that you let go a person who pled guilty, but did not, in the same case, did not let the individual go who helped the government win the case. So that makes no sense. That's ass backwards. that doesn't make any sense at all. So I guess that's the point that Judge Englemayer is trying to make. And that's a great point, by the way. Even the people that really dislike and don't like Tekashi, I mean, let's not say it's Tekashi. Let's say it's a whole totally different in the way. You don't like rats or snakes from the game. So, okay, so you're going to have the same opinion. But you understand, but you understand my point, though. How are you going to let the guy go that pled guilty, but not let the guy go that helped you in court and took the stand? That doesn't make sense. It sounds to me like there might be some kind of, I don't know, it could just be because he's Tekashi 6ix9ine. They just don't want to let him go. You feel me? That could just be it. And I'm not talking about the judge. I'm talking about the, you know, whoever's the say-so that they need, you know. But apparently Judge Englemayer is going to step in. Let me know what y'all guys think. I want to know, let y'all know, what do y'all think about Judge Englemayer about this, by the way? Like, forget the fact that it's Tekashi 6ix9ine. I'm just saying, just if it was just any old, any individual that was locked up and incarcerated, let's not even say whether the person snitched or not. That's not the, because that's not what I'm talking about. I'm just saying, what do you think about Judge Englemayer after seeing how, in my opinion, he's been fair? If you don't think he's been fair, leave it down. If you think he's been fair or not, leave that down in the comments also. But what do you think about Judge Englemayer, how hard he's going for just the appropriate treatment that an individual should receive? I don't know what to tell you, but at this point, you know, has he ever thought about running for office? Because anyway, leave it down in the comment section. I want to know what you guys think about this. I want to know if you guys think they should let him go, shouldn't let him go. I want to know if you guys think that especially dependent on the fact that Kuda B has been allowed to go free now. Especially dependent on that fact, do you think that Tekashi 6ix9ine should also be allowed to go? Remember, he only got about 4 months. Tekashi 6ix9ine only has about 4 months to serve. It's not like he got 2, 3, 6 years. He got 4 months to serve. Do you think he should be allowed to come home? I'm curious. Personally, if you want to know my personal opinion, I'll tell you. Your opinion does not have to line up with mine. But my opinion is, this is a very serious situation. If you catch this inside of the prison, your ability to fight it off and stay alive drastically diminishes. An individual who only has a couple, I think they should let everybody go that has like 5 months. just so we could be clear on this. I've said this already. I think every single person, we was having a discussion about, it was a different discussion. We was having a discussion about legalizing marijuana nationwide. What would they do with the people that are currently locked up and in prison because of marijuana charges? And I said that if you have anybody that only has like less than half a year to serve, they should just be let go, period. And everybody else, whatever their sentence was, should just be cut in half. So if you had a 12-year sentence and you've served 7, then you should go home, because half a 12 would be 6. So anyway, point being is, let me know what y'all guys think about this. I'm just curious. honestly. And also, would you have thought this was an April Fool's joke? I want to know if anybody else would have thought this was an April Fool's joke. It's not an April Fool's joke. Shout out to Inner City Press. I hope he takes it with a grain of salt. Like, comment, subscribe. Join the notification gang. Hashtag Bronx Bombers. Let's get it. I love y'all. Take care of each other. Hug the kids for me. I haven't forgotten about you. And that's all I got on this one. I'm out. If you like this video, please hit the like and subscribe button. If you would like to help dictate the direction that this channel takes, please leave a comment. All comments are appreciated, whether positive or negative. Thank you very much and enjoy your day. And remember, positive thoughts cause for positive things to happen. Let's get it.
Oh, Black Dynamite, I wish it was that simple, but this is much bigger than you and me.
Hey, little mama. It may be bigger than you, and it may be bigger than me, but it ain't bigger than you and me. Can you dig it?